Wait till you're an hour.
Well, they bring up she did.
We've not yet lost our grace.
It's Pittsburgh.
Your eyes will stay in
chains.
Look upon you, greatness that you
sent.
Until we live in cities, you'll never see on screen. Not very pretty, but we sure know how to run things. Living in ruins of a palace within my dreams. And you know, we're on each other's team.
She's a professional racer. So, Tom, what do you think?
Four laps down, green flag in the air. Let's get it on here. Bobby Santos takes him down into turn number one, and he's got Cody Swanson right on his tail tank pad as they come down the back track.
Well, the other driver who made a big, strong move was Taylor Ferns in the 55, who ducked down to the bottom and has moved forward. And now Taylor runs in the fifth position, or at least in a battle for that in the 55. Went around, and there's Grant in the Dennis LeCava prepared car.
So there was a good battle going on right at the restart between the 55 of Taylor Ferns and the 92 of Jim Anderson. That battle is not going away, not yet. Up front, you've got kind of two separate two-car packs. The leader, Bobby Santos, has Justin Grant, let's say three car lengths behind him. And then there's a good gap. Third is Cody Swanson, and he's got David Byrne right behind him in fourth. And then it's a three-car pack right there, the number 92 of Jim Anderson. Guys are also spotting the Indianapolis 500 tomorrow, Pat. So everybody this weekend is very busy in central Indiana.
They're professionals as well and very important to the operation.
Well, right here, big moment, rolling out of four. That's going to be the number 55 of Taylor Ferns, and she's got the number 92 of Jim Anderson, who you've done a good job of highlighting, Pat.
Oh, he's a good racer, but very interesting. That's been quite a battle there.
Fern has to fall back in position.
He'll fight you every inch of the way, and by the way, while these two think they've got a private battle, they happen to be wrong, because they're hitting the loud pedal is Taylor Ferns, and she's just reaching out and grabbing up hunks of pavement.
Gets it done. Move David Byrne up to the third.
Yeah, look at Taylor Ferns tries to go right down to the bottom, and Justin Grant is pressing enough to know he had to block that move. Justin had the slightest of bubbles between one and two. That's all David Byrne needed.
You talked about David Byrne's 2020 season, Pat. He had a terrible season. Didn't finish hardly a single race. He says, I'm going to finish every race this year, and I'm going to go get me some points. He's now on the podium in third position. We got one around over in turn two. Taylor Ferns goes to work on the inside of last year's champion, Justin Grant.
Whoa.
Grant gets in the throttle, and Taylor Ferns has a quick moment there. She gathers it back up.
Well, there may have been contact there between the two of them, too far away for us to tell for sure. Now, Taylor's going to regather and focus again, and Logan Seavey doesn't want to give her any time to regroup. He wants to take that spot as well.
You're exactly right. Seavey now sets his sights on the black and red, number 55. That's the fight for fifth position. Seavey's got a good run going down the back straightaway here. Can he make anything happen? No. Ferns is able to get deep into that corner, but Seavey rolls good on corner exit. Seavey's going to take a look down into one and two. Now he's going to stay back in line. Ferns stays alive for at least one more lap. Six to go next time by.
Yeah, Cody Swanson right now, he's got the kite string all the way out as he heads into turn number four.
Swanson's going to lead him off here.
Top three is separate. Now Justin Grant's able to hold on to that fourth position for now.
Victory lane. Hey, quick shout out to fifth place finisher Taylor Ferns, the number 55 of Taylor Ferns, her first Silver Crown race. Richie Murray reminds us, in 7 years.
Right. It's been a long time.
And a top five finish, and she was battling defending series champion Justin Krant for a position there late in the going.
She's a good racer, and I feel good for her.
So that was...
On Derek Bichek. He's going to want to stab the pedal, and here we go. Santos gets out front, and guess who's right behind him, Kim?
Oh, not a question at all. That is Cody Swanson. He was. And it is Bobby Santos. He's going to lead that first lap, followed across by Cody Swanson in the 77.
Look for just a moment there that there might be an attempt to try to go three wide. Dakota Armstrong thought the better of it in that green and white number one car. They're almost three wide there, and some
one
scrapes the wall over there and turn.
I'm kind of older than I was when I rebelled without a care. So there.
Okay, Taylor, we're gonna do another pass, a drive-by on the driver's side, right?
Passenger side.
On the passenger side. So back off a bit, and then just get a little start. Passenger side pass again. Probably coming up here in the straightaway.
Field makes their way through turns three and four. This could be the start of a $100,000 payday if you're one of the five drivers chasing it. Tom Hansing shows them the green flag. We're racing, and not a very good start up front for the 51 of Gamester. Everybody's going to fan out through turns one and two. Boy, Pat, for a moment, it looked like they were trying to cram as many cars as they could down the front straightaway. They've all got it sorted out down in the back straightaway into turns three and four. The field comes unwinding out of that final corner, but that looks to be the 26, Aaron Pierce.
Aaron Pierce gets the early lead. Of course, we had the big invert, and that made a big difference there. Aaron Pierce out front in the 26.
And Cody Swanson goes to work from the third position. Now he's going to race for second, and he's going to roll up on the 55, Miss Taylor Ferns.
Now, Taylor Ferns, who had a good run in the Summer Crown Series here earlier this year, pavement veteran from Shelby Township, Michigan. Shelby Tough. There's Cody Swanson closing in turn number three.
Well, and remember, we saw Taylor Ferns run back during the Carbonite Classic in May, and she looked really, really good. Ran fifth place, but now she's got the winningest driver in Silver Crown Series history right behind her. 50 laps, the green flag. But these aren't Silver Crown cars, Pat. These are pavement sprint cars. Cody Swanson almost as deadly in those.
Well, he is really sizing up Taylor Ferns right now. He also knows he's got to maintain the tires. No need for haste, and both of them have started to close the gap on Aaron Pierce, who's out front.
Swanson takes a look that time just to kind of see what Taylor Ferns is doing on corner entry. Behind them, Billy Weiss runs in fourth, and then Tanner Swanson sits in fifth. Remember, he started this race one row ahead of brother Cody. Sixth is Kyle O'Gara, Tyler Roerig, seventh, Caleb Armstrong, Bobby Santos, and Joe Liguori, the driver from Tampa, Florida, sits in 10th.
Right there, you saw that Cody Swanson took a peek to the inside of Taylor Ferns. Again, if you...
How's it going, Scott?
Good.
Good job, Jeannie Weenie.
Quick time.
There's your quick time.
Good call for 1 and 2 out. It's Jason Blood, Taylor Ferns. 10 laps is what this could go. Jason Blood down the back stretch. Taylor Ferns trying to reel him in. Two champions in their own right.
Took advantage of it. Dove down underneath for the
win. Yeah.
She's
got to
fix her hair, Scott.
Yeah,
winner, winner, chicken dinner.
I wish you could feel it at home where you're watching us. The grandstands are going to shake. I'll turn the microphone on outside here, and I'll just kind of – you can hear the noise and just how loud. All right, sprint cars getting ready to go under green for the final time at Berlin Raceway in the 2021 season. We're underway. Taylor Ferns, fastest car of the racetrack, 15.989, 16-second lap in these little sprint cars. She's in the 55 from Detroit area. Here goes back to second. Taylor Ferns now, she is third in the 55. She looks to the inside of Liguori, trying to make the pass. It's a battle for second. She got down on the inside before and had to back out of it during the heat race. This time, she makes it six and sets her sights on the leader. Liguori still 21 laps to go. There's a long way to go on this one. She's got the time. Last couple laps, she was the fastest car on the racetrack. 55, Ferns, there she is. Boy, her car looks hooked up.
Yeah.
Down to the inside, she looks. Liguori at the outside. Ferns at the inside, can't make the pass. 10 down, 20 laps to go. The lap traffic is coming. That might be her next best chance. Armstrong so far has played solid defense the whole night. There's a lap car, and that's exactly what it took. Put on my crystal ball. That was enough. Ferns is able to make the pass, so she's going to take off, or if it stays green. Heavy traffic, she weaves her way through that one. Tense moments, wow, here comes second and third. Working their way through. She just threaded the needle and went right through. No issues at all, going to be the white flag this time by. White flag, the final lap at Berlin Raceway in the 2021 season. Lead about a second over Armstrong. Santos still runs third, and that's probably how they're going to finish. Taylor Ferns win. Second place, Dakota Armstrong, Bobby Santos.
They push start him, so they'll probably be there for a little bit.
Mark, right on the start-finish line.
My number one support system, the Sanford Law Firm. When I get your call, Sam, they're right employee.
rentals, perfect. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Happy for you guys.
Thank you so much.
Never come down. Mama said, don't give up. It's a little complicated. All tied up, no more love. And I'd hate to see you waiting. They say it's all been done, but they haven't seen the best of me. So I got one more run, and it's gonna be a sight to see.
Qualified will be the young lady from Shelby Township, Michigan. Taylor Ferns Racing is the entrant. She's got Sam Bernstein Law Firm on the side of her beast with a Stan Mopar from Shelby Township, Michigan. In car number 55, this is Taylor Ferns.
Taylor Ferns has spent the bulk of her career racing open wheel cars on the pavement and doing that quite successfully. We saw her have a great run in Summer Crown competition much earlier in the year.
She's our 10th car to take time here at Fat Ed's Eyewear Qualifying. We've seen a lot of guys go second quick. How about first? Right to the top of the charts. 15.473. Taylor Ferns bucks the trend of laying down second quick lap first time out. She is the quickest after one lap.
Carried a lot of speed down the back straightaway. Let's see if Taylor can improve, Tony. Looks like she does.
Great lap there, 15.470. We saw her run to a fifth place finish at the Carb Night Classic at Lucas Oil Raceway. On track now.
Have high hopes for a living. Shooting for the stars when I couldn't make a killing.